literally the backbone of 1,000 industries, a long line of furnaces holds steel in the making. Steel that will someday enter your life, perhaps carry you safely on some journey, provide you with shelter, create an endless variety of comforts and conveniences. Just the proper percentages of carbon and other elements are retained so that it will possess the exact characteristics needed.
This is not something easy to find. You have to go to a college that does this normally to find this way of working. I want to make this available in the way of encouraging other graffiti artists to work in the industrial arts and work with their hands in three dimension and also work in the ever-emerging and expanding digital realm.
What's really nice about the organization is that it's preserving this whole industrial space for artists to come look at it, be inspired by it, and then go make art.
The iron that came out of these furnaces literally built America's 20th century. So it's Panama Canal gates, it's the Empire State Building, Sears Tower, on and on and on. Seemingly overnight to the people in this region, all that work disappears. And so these places that were, you know, site of employment for 150,000 people are transformed. The work goes away, and then people start looking at these sites very differently.
When it was vacant, this was our art gallery. It was amazing. It was just for us. But during the days, we would come in paint, and at night, we'd be in train yards, or we'd be on the East Busway, or we had Mad Cuddy spots to paint because of all the hills here.
You know, the first thought, and this is a natural thought for people, is that, oh, they're coming in because they want to destroy something. But the realization was, is that's not why people are coming in here. They weren't coming in here because they wanted to destroy it. They were coming in here because they loved it. And they were creating something new and beautiful here. They're not diametrically opposed. They're actually symbiotic. And it really does work together.
Within the art program, we think about this post-industrial period as really being that key period where the arts plays an integral role in helping contribute to the interpretation. Graffiti's a huge piece of that.
The interest of sculpture was already built into painting in the 70s, when writers were alluding to three dimensions in their letters and pursued sculpting as a way of elevating graffiti and style writing.
Graffiti wanted to jump off of the wall, and we were already painting it, trying to make it as three-dimensional as possible.
So it was there, but it wasn't realized in physical form until 1984, when Phase Two did his letter A sculpture. That was the same year I did my first sculpture, and I believe Ramelzi was also beginning to do his letter erasers.
I started in 1997. I really had Phase Two and his work to look at, and you know, Delta Zeds in Amsterdam. We saw something in modernism and futurism and constructivism and applied graffiti to it.
I was cutting the sculptures in a South Bronx rooftop by hand with metal that I stole from the mass transit system.
The reaction in the gallery when I did the first piece was so overwhelming that I started chasing it and have never stopped.
I was picking up behaviors or rhythms that I was finding through the breakdancers, how things would pop, weave into each other. So that was built into Wild Style. From there, I started thinking about sculpture in a whole different way, rather than sticking to the letter form, that it could actually be a free form, a freestyle. It's arduous from the beginning when you start making your molds and you start shaping it, getting it ready for this process that is slightly imperfect because you're dealing with all kinds of elements of sand and oil and air and fire.
For me, it certainly is a great way of appreciating the challenges and the difficulty of working in a space like this whenever it was an industrial mill. You get the danger, you get the heat, you get the sweat and the hard work.
A couple things that happened that were really unique in this residency. Finally realizing new work is one, but also having this reunion of sorts with Michael and some other people that helped me in 2016. They saw the sculptures that I made last time that were smaller B-Boy abstract sculptures and helped me with that. And so now they're seeing them like 4 feet tall and encouraging me and helping me realize something that weighs perhaps 800 pounds.
I've been making this wall sculpture in small scale using 3D printers, and I thought it would be really interesting to do it in a variety of scales and cast it in iron. I utilized a lot of different mold making techniques and CNC technology. The other work that I made was very reminiscent of a letter or letters. Each person keeps seeing a different letter in it, which was very true to the graffiti work that I paint.
The arts thrive in this place that has this weighted history, but it brings us all together to work as a community towards one goal, which is that poor.
I was somehow in these abandoned sites, almost taken over by this industry and the ghost of it and its spirit. The amount of energy that was expelled here, if you think about that, is pretty hard to grapple with. I think it would be only appropriate that someone from a city like Pittsburgh would work in this medium and continue to.
The opportunity that Rivers of Steel affords someone like me and Michael, who believes very strongly in the ethos of hard work, smart work, forward-thinking work, work that does not come easy. This is a place for people like us.